Welcome to the Transformation Show at AllisonPhillips.tv. Redefining business and life experiences through the wisdom and power of universal principles. Here's your host, international speaker, award-winning author, and business success coach, Allison Phillips.
Welcome back, everybody, to another episode of the Transformation Show here on AllisonPhillips.tv. I am your host, Allison Phillips. How y'all been? I've been a while, right, since I did a video. Well, actually, it depends on where you are. If you're on YouTube, you probably haven't heard of either seen a video from me in about a month or so. If you're on my email list, you probably heard from me a couple of weeks ago. If you are in my monthly event, you probably heard from me just about every week, especially, particularly if you've been posting questions during the month that you're in that event. So it depends on where you are. But I am doing another video today, and hopefully it will be helpful to you. This was really inspired by my own deeper understanding of this concept. And basically what I do on this show, for those of you who are new, I really just share what I'm experiencing, the things that I'm gaining clarity on and how I'm gaining clarity on it. And I also answer some viewer questions from time to time as well. So this show is really on how to vibrationally direct the events of your life, the experiences of your life, and I'm going to share five different concepts with you in this episode. For those of you who are new, welcome, and you can find out more about me at AllisonPhillips.tv/about. If you are wanting some playlists, you can find them here on YouTube. You can find them also on my website as well, AllisonPhillips.tv. To find out more about the show, AllisonPhillips.tv/show. If you want to submit questions, you can do them on YouTube. You can do them also on the show page over at AllisonPhillips.tv/show. Either way is fine. I find that I'm answering questions or responding to people on YouTube faster because there's this one panel where I see every single thing that people post, no matter which video you posted under, it all shows up in one place. And I find it easier to peruse things that way. I'm falling a little bit behind, okay? The comments are coming in faster than I can keep pace with. So sometimes you may hear back from me in a couple of hours. Sometimes it may be a couple of weeks. It depends on what's going on and the pace at which I'm able to get to your comments. I know it'll get to a place where I can't respond to every single person, but right now I really am continuing to respond to people. And while I'm on that, a couple of shout outs. Rochelle Griffith, hi, welcome to the to my YouTube channel. She and I had talked a little bit about the perfection of the timing of the universe. Welcome, girl. Carol Williams, I hope you got the link from my assistant for that private video that I shared with my list a while back. Welcome to you too. Glad to talk to you on YouTube. Maria Shona Adlawan, hi, and welcome to my YouTube channel as well. You and I talked too. Brooke Hoole, and I think it's Brooke Hoole or Brooke Hoole. I don't know. I don't know how to pronounce it. She is 18. She was writing to me on YouTube talking about, she found my videos at 3 a.m. and did not sleep and went straight to her classes at school at 8 o'clock in the morning. I was like, what? But, the cool thing, I thought it was fascinating that at 18, you're getting all of these concepts, girl. What your life will be if you begin to embrace more and more these concepts of how to live spiritually awakened and understanding really how this universe works, which is a lot of what I'm going to be sharing about in this video here today. So just a shout out to Brooke. I know you posted a couple times. There is somebody, Kate Beckett. Hey, girl. Richard G. Totally felt your comments, dude. Let's see. Georgina, you sign your comments on YouTube, Gina. I can't respond to you, girl. I have no idea why. Your comments are not appearing on my videos, although I see them in the back end of my YouTube channel. Check your YouTube channel to see if you're blocking your comments from actually being visible. So anyway, just a few shout outs to a few people. Now let's get into how to vibrationally direct the experiences of your life. Now, there's a note that I have posted on my, you can't see it, so I'll read it, on my monitor that says, and someone sent this to me and I was like, man, I'm totally feeling that. So I actually printed it out and put it on my monitor. It says, you are the vibrational writers of the script of your life. Listen to this, y'all. I'm gonna start over because y'all gotta get this, okay? You are the vibrational writers of the script of your life, and everyone else in the universe is playing the part that you have assigned to them. Now, how do you assign a part to others in your experience, okay? It's through your predominant thoughts, emotions, beliefs, expectations, and focus. Remember that. Thoughts, emotions, beliefs, expectations, and focus. This is how we direct the experiences of our lives and the events of our lives. Now, this is coming from my own personal beliefs. You know, guys, you guys know how I flow on this show. Take what resonates, discard what does not. My own personal belief is that everything that I desire already exists in a vibrational reality. So I don't have to work that hard to experience it. I really just need to get in vibrational resonance with what I desire in order to have it unfold in this experience that I'm having here. Some people call it vibrational reality. Some people call it parallel realities. I believe in parallel realities. I believe in vibrational realities. I believe that every thought that occurs in my mind manifests in a vibrational reality. And I have access to that vibrational reality through my predominant thoughts, emotions, beliefs, expectations, and focus. So let's talk about vibrationally directing the script of your life. And I want to share it from this perspective. When we decided to come express as a human being, when our souls decided to come to planet Earth, to this earthly ride, which I call a theme park. If you want to see my little video clip on that, go to allisonphillips.tv/theme park. I had to give it its own link because I refer to it so much. That's how I see the world, right? That's how I see this life experiences, the life experiences that we're having here. We knew, our souls knew coming into our human bodies that we could handle it all. Anything that comes our way, we knew we could handle it because we knew the greater part of us, the spirit part of us. Some people call it consciousness, inner being, whatever you want to call it, what label. We make up all these labels here on Earth anyway. Spirit, inner being, consciousness, whatever you want to call it. That greater part of us came in to express, like I am infinite intelligence expressing as Allison, right? So that greater part of us, that God part of us, is always present. And so when our souls decided to come in and express as this human expression, we also knew that we were bringing into this human expression everything that was divine and powerful, like remarkably powerful. We knew that we were bringing that part of us into this earthly expression. We knew that. Our souls knew that. So our souls wasn't scared about anything that we're going to experience because our souls already knew all the different options that were out there for our experiences. Now we do have, I believe, some people believe we have no free will whatsoever. I do believe that we have free will by what we choose to focus on and what we choose to think about and the things that we choose to manifest, right? Another point of clarification also before I get into the five ways to vibrationally manifest things in your life, vibrationally direct the course of your life. A lot of times people say, I'm learning how to manifest them. I got to learn how to manifest what I want. And understand, folks, you're always manifesting. If you are waking up and you're having a life experience, either on the way to work or waking up and having an experience in your business, if you are having human experiences, you're the only one manifesting it, okay? Every life experience you have, every event that emerges throughout the day, you are manifesting it. So we don't have to learn how to manifest. We just need to tweak the manifestation of our life experiences, which is the focus of what I'm going to talk about today. So that's a backdrop for my own belief system that is what I believe. Take what resonates, discard what does not. I believe that my soul knew fully well what Allison was going to experience in this lifetime and knew that Allison could handle it all, okay? Even though there was moments, as you guys have seen in past videos, where I thought I couldn't handle it all, wanted to take myself out, okay? But here I am, still here, right? Because our souls knew what we were going to, who we were going to be, right? I believe that our souls knew who our parents were going to be, our souls knew who our kids were going to be. All of that was all set before we were born into this earthly experience. Now, the analogy is this. Think of your life, think of you. You, okay? I mean, in the greater part of you, not this this human part of us, this human expression is, in my opinion, in my belief, a minuscule part of who we truly are. We're just down here prancing around on planet Earth for a little bit, and then we go back to being infinite, eternal, indestructible beings. That's what I believe, right? I also say oftentimes, I don't believe in death. I believe that death is just us saying, okay, I'm done with this game on Earth, and I'm going to move on to something else, okay? Our souls are moving on. Our souls is eternal. It's not going to die. So I don't believe in death as we define it as human beings here on Earth. I believe it's just a transition to another realm, and we're moving, our souls is moving on to another adventure. So the analogy is, you are the director and the writer of the script of your life, based on what I shared in that thing. You are the vibrational writer of the script of your life. So we, if you're the director of the script of your life and you are the writer of the script of your life, you're affecting what's happening in your experience. And I believe, again, you can choose to believe whatever you want. I believe there's nothing occurring in the experience of Allison that Allison is not creating, okay? And we have a hard time with that because we think, wait a minute. I would never have chosen to have this experience in my life if you had some traumatic experience or whatever these different things are. I believe that we're the writers or directors of the script of our lives. I believe our souls knew long before we came here precisely what we're going to experience. Now, if you are the writer and the director of the script of your life, it starts to look kind of funny when things are unfolding in your life and you're like, I don't like this. I don't like this. I don't want, why is this happening, right? If you are the writer and the director, the actors are just playing the roles that you have assigned to them through the script that you wrote. Right? So if your child is acting up or your spouse is, you know, acting in a way that you don't like or your partner is or your parents are or all of these things are occurring, I believe the most powerful perspective to stand in is I just need to rewrite the script. Y'all, hold on to that, okay? Hold on to that because it's powerful. When things are unfolding in your life where you're like, I don't understand why this is happening. Why is that happening? This is, you just pause and go, I just need to rewrite the script. Because the script that I wrote, the actors are not playing out in the way that I thought they would. I need to go back and adjust the script. So for me, when things play out in my life, that's how I see it. I see it as, oh, I'm the director, I'm the writer of the script of my life. I'm writing it and directing it vibrationally. And a lot of times the word vibration is just woo-woo to death in our spiritual community. It's just woo-woo to death. All it means is, what are you predominantly feeling, thinking, expecting, and believing, and focusing on? That's really all it means. Because we are vibrational beings living in a vibrational universe is what I believe. Okay, we are vibrational beings living in a vibrational universe. That's my belief. So for me, if I want to adjust anything in my external circumstance, I simply adjust me vibrationally. Again, simply by my predominant thoughts, emotions, beliefs, expectations, all of that, right? So some examples of that, when somebody in our lives, like a parent or a sibling or a child or a spouse or a partner, whatever it is acting in a certain way that we think is unacceptable or we don't like it or it's ticking us off, making us mad, making us upset, whatever it is. We wrote that script through our predominant emotions. Because a lot of times, because we say, no, it's them. But I believe we live in a vibrational universe, and I believe that I am creating everything that I'm experiencing. That is what I believe. So for me, I don't care how you behave, and I don't care what choices you're making. I don't care what's happening here. I know that I am powerful enough. I believe that I have the power to vibrationally direct the script of my life. So a lot of times when things are playing out in our experience, it's really coming about as a result of our predominant expectations, beliefs, the thoughts that we have. If you think about a partner, if your partner does something that you're mad at, we are more likely as human beings to expect that behavior in future. Well, expectation is part of how you write the script. So if you expect a certain outcome, oh, they did that, watch, they're gonna do it the same way again. Have you ever heard yourself say that? I just knew they weren't gonna do it. That's how he acts. That's how he acts. That's an expectation, okay? And it's hard, it's challenging for us as human beings to see something play out and not expect it to happen again. So it's by our predominant expectation that things are reoccurring in our experiences as well. And I'll talk about some other things too. So let me get into, those are some backdrops for how I see it. So a lot of times when we're like, oh my gosh, how is this happening, right? It's kind of like the director, think of a director of a movie. The writer, so you are the writer and the director of the movie of your life. I am the writer and director of the movie called Allison Phillips, okay? Now, the movie's playing out, the actors are doing what I wrote in the script, and now I'm getting ticked off that they're following the script that I wrote, right? So whenever I see people like going crazy about their life circumstances, I just want for them to understand that they are the vibrational writers of the script of their lives, and everyone else in the universe is playing the roles that we have assigned to them vibrationally. So when we're going, oh my gosh, why is she doing this? Why is she doing this? You know, we're like, because you wrote it in the script vibrationally, right? It's the vibrational script that's playing out in your life through your expectations. Have you ever like stood, you know, in an event or somewhere where you kind of go, I bet this is what's going to happen. And then it plays out and you go, I just knew it. Well, you knew it because you wrote the script vibrationally through that expectation, predominant thoughts, predominant emotions, predominant beliefs, predominant expectations, predominant focus. That is how we're directing the script of our lives. So number one is believe that you are the vibrational writer of the script of your life. Because if you don't believe that, then you just kind of living life thinking everything is happening to you. It's like, why is this happening to me, right? And it's happening because it is a vibrational match to where you are right now. So sometimes people talk about family members or friendships or partnerships or marriages or whatever that they're in, and they're like, well, how is this happening? Well, it's because believe what you want to believe. You can choose how you want to see your life experience. For me, when things play out that are kind of ugly, or it's not what I expected, or it's not what I want to experience, it's an unwanted thing that's playing out, I go, well, I do believe this is a vibrational universe, which means this could not be occurring unless I was a vibrational match to it occurring. Okay? And for me, I just accept that as the way the universe works. I am a vibrational match to your crap right now, which is why I'm experiencing it. Because if I wasn't a vibrational match to your crap, I probably would not be in this situation that's unfolding right here. And that's how I see it. So number one is believe that you are the vibrational writer and director of the script of your life. And then that everyone is playing the role that you have assigned to them vibrationally. Number two is to not take your cue from your circumstances. So a lot of times what we do as director and writer is, say the script is playing out in a way that we vibrationally wrote it, but we don't like it. What we do is we start screaming at the actors, right? And we start having a hissy fit with the actors. Why are you treating me this way? Why is this happening, right? All of these different things, right? And what we're doing in that situation is we're allowing the circumstance to direct our emotions. We don't have to live that way. It's one of the most challenging things for human beings to accept and to gain vibrational control over. When a situation is playing out, you don't have to let that situation be the director of you. You the director. You the writer. Okay? So you can stay in your role, which you decided. I mean, we decided to come here and be the directors and writers of the script of our lives. We really, truly did. Now, we knew that we'd write a few really not so wanted scenes every once in a while because, raising my hand, sometimes I write some scripts that really I didn't mean to write, okay? But I wrote them, okay? So we knew that we were going to have some of those experiences as well where we're vibrationally writing scripts that's playing out as life events for us where we're like, yes, I could see how I created that, but I didn't mean to. Okay, let me hang on. Let me go back to the table and rewrite that script, please, you know? And I do have some of those experiences where I see clearly how I'm vibrationally writing that script, and but I know that I can rewrite the script. So another way to stay in vibrational direction of the experiences of your life is to accept that you do not have to let the circumstance determine your emotions, which is kind of like a catch 22, right? Because you know that you are vibrationally writing the script of your life through your emotions. So if you are reacting to what the actors are doing rather than just going back and rewriting the script and adjusting the script, if you're, you know, like getting discouraged, angry, fearful, pissed off, you know, despair, and you're getting all of those emotions because of what the actors in your little movie are doing, then it's a catch 22 because now they're directing your emotions and your emotions is what is directing the script, right? So it's just this going back and forth where you don't realize, wait a minute, whoa, hang on. I am the director here. The circumstance is not the director. You're just playing out because I made a little boo-boo in the script here. So let me just go redo the script, right? But instead, we look at our life circumstance and we react to what we're seeing rather than looking at it going, oh, this is just letting me know. This is the thing, right? This is the thing. When you do not take your cues from your circumstances, you look at the circumstance and you go, oh, you're just there to let me know that I need to adjust the script. That's the only reason it's playing out. And we give it all kinds of meaning. You think of me this way, you're judging me. We get into all that stuff, right? When the only thing that that situation is telling you, I don't care what that unwanted situation is with a spouse, with a parent, I don't care what it is. All that situation is telling you is, psst, adjust the script. That's all it's telling you. But we think it means all kinds of things. It means that I'm less worthy. It means that I'm wrong. It means that I'm a horrible manifester. It means that we give it all kinds of meaning, right? Where the circumstance is just going, hello, red flag. I'm waving a flag that you just need to go back to the writing and adjust the script. And how do we adjust the script? Same way. The same way that we created it. Through our predominant thoughts, emotions, beliefs, expectations, and focus. So you just go back and you go, okay, so I need to focus on what I want, not on this circumstance, which is one of the greatest challenges is because we choose to take our cue from the circumstance, we let it tell us how to feel. I have this saying in my own life experience where I go, no circumstance, I am not taking my cue from you. You do not tell me how to feel. You do not tell me what to believe. And I literally speak to the circumstance, whatever it is. And I go, you're not the director of my life. I am. Okay. Because a lot of what we do as human beings is we go, okay, circumstance, tell me how to feel. Oh, there's no money in my bank account. Okay. Thank you. I will feel horrible. Now, there is also a vibrational reality where you do have an abundance of money. Now you could choose to focus on this reality, which is our physical reality that's playing out, or you can choose to focus on the vibrational reality, which is equally true. In a parallel reality, in a vibrational reality, there is you having everything that you desire, the finances and all of that. If we can allow ourselves to be in the place where we are shifting our focus to the vibrational reality, which does also exist, I believe, I don't know what you believe, but I believe it also exists, then you can say to the physical circumstance, thank you for showing me that I need to adjust the script. I will now go focus on my vibrational reality in order to have a different life event play out, to adjust how my life events are playing out. Rather than looking at the script and trying to looking at the actors and trying to fight with them, you know, just say, hang on a second, take a seat, actors. I'm just going to go back and adjust the script. Okay. And again, you're adjusted through your vibration, your focus. What are you focused on? The thing that's playing out or the thing that's in your vibrational reality? The only way to affect what's playing out is to become so vibrationally resonant with the vibrational reality, the parallel reality version of you, to become so vibrationally resonant with that, that it cannot help but manifest into your new script, right? The events that are playing out in your life. Okay, so the second one was, do not take your cue from your circumstances. Do not let the actors tell you what to do. You are the director. You are the writer. They're just acting out what you have vibrationally determined for them to act out. Okay. So, and a lot of times when I say this to people, they say, well, what if, so you're telling me to work on me. So what if I change and they don't? But the only reason you can have that thought is by the false premise that you have no control over the events that play out in your life. The only reason you can have that thought is because you don't understand that if you shift vibrationally, everything outside of you, including the way people interact, also begins to change and shift because you changed and shift. But you cannot do it from the perspective of, okay, I'm going to do what Allison says. I'm just going to focus on my reality. And then every 2 seconds you're going, did it change? Did it change? Did it change? If you're doing that, you have not fully focused. You're offering a split vibe, as I have shared in other videos. So you really... we really get to the place, or we can actually get to the place where most of what we feel during the day is vibrationally resonant with our parallel reality, our vibrational reality. And we're so tuned into that, that it matters not what's playing out here, because we so believe our expectations is so tuned into that. Our thoughts is so tuned into that. Our beliefs, our emotions is so tuned into that, that we just believe that is going to play out next. Right? And it begins to, because that's what we choose to focus on. So number two, do not take your cue from the circumstances. Don't let the circumstances and people in your external reality be the director. You're the director of the script of your life. The third one is, actually I addressed this as well, but I'll emphasize it here. Understand that the vibrational reality is as real as what is physically occurring in your experience right now. The reason we are so obsessed with what is happening in our physical reality is because we're not aware that the vibrational reality of the experience that we desire is as real as what's happening in our physical reality. So as human beings, we're so into the physical reality. It's like, oh my God, look at what's happening now. Look at what's happening now. Look at what's happening now. And we're like so focused on what's happening right now. What's happening right now? And we do not believe as strongly in the fact that a vibrational reality does exist. When we do believe that vibrational reality does exist, we begin to embrace that, wait a minute, I could focus on this reality or I can focus on this reality. And when we're truly focused on this reality, more of it just begins to unfold in our experience, which is why I believe creating your own reality and manifesting is a bit of a misnomer, because all of those realities already exist. All we do is adjust our inner vibe to line up with it, and it begins to unfold in our experience and things begin to shift and change. And it's really powerful when you start playing with this. I have done this in relationships with family members where I understood, okay, I am the vibrational writer of the script of my life. Now this is occurring and I don't like it. So really all that's telling me is adjust the script. So I would go into the place where I would see that person the way that I want to experience them. I would feel what that felt like. I would really totally engulf myself in the experience of what it was like to experience that person in a different way. And without talking about it, you know, when things go awry, we go, we need to have a talk, right? Even without doing any of that, things began to shift and the circumstances began to change. And it was like the person was becoming a different person. And I was like, well, damn. We don't realize just how powerful we are, right? To affect the circumstances of our lives. If we are in vibrational resonance with the reality that we prefer, and we really do become consistently resonant with that reality, not always checking to see or not going, well, it's not working. Because some people, what we do sometimes is we look at the vibrational reality and we're there and we're like, okay, I'm experiencing it and I'm going to stay tuned into that vibrational reality. But, you know, a week would go by and we're like, well, they're still acting up. You know, and then we just leave that and we go back to focusing on the physical reality. And if we can only get to the place where we can stay with that vibrational reality as the reality we choose to focus on, not for any length of time, but just, I just choose to believe that this is going to be how my life is going to be. And you just stay there, right? You will begin to see things shifting in your experience without you doing much of anything, because we live in a vibrational universe. But it is when we keep digging up the seed, like we planted that seed of like being in that vibrational reality, but we keep digging it up to see if it's growing, right? And it's like, well, it's been a week. Well, it's been a month. I really needed that solution like yesterday, right? But when you start having those thoughts, you are no longer vibrationally resonant with vibrational reality. You can't be in vibrational resonance with that vibrational reality and also have thoughts of, why is it not occurring? Why is it not here yet? I've been doing this for so long and I don't see any change. If you're having all of those thoughts, you're not fully resonant with that vibrational reality, which is why a lot of people do the law of attraction thing and they go, it's not working. Because they're doing processes, but they're also going, is it working? Is it working? Is it working? Which means you're offering a split vibration. Because to check whether it's working, you first have to have the thought that it might not, because you're checking, right? So that's how we offer the split vibe that causes us to just stay where we are, or even create even more of the things that we consider to be unwanted. Okay, so again, number one, believe that you are truly the vibrational writer of the script of your life. Number two, do not take your cue from circumstances. They are not the director. All your circumstances are saying to you is, hey, rewrite the script. That's all it's saying. Number three, realize that your vibrational reality is as real as the physical reality that you're focusing on, that most human beings choose to focus on. Number four is, see all of the emotions that you're feeling, because you know, you guys have heard me say this more than once. Anytime you're feeling unwanted emotions, it just says that you are out of alignment with the perspective of source. So even your emotions is a cue, right? Because you could look at circumstances, or you could look at a spouse that said something, you know, to you that hurt your feelings or something, and you could like totally obsess about that, right? Rather than saying, well, that's an interesting cue, I'm gonna rewrite the script. But the same thing occurs for our emotions as well. When you're in an emotional state of fear, or expecting something bad to happen, or this isn't working, all these different things that we feel emotionally, of course we can't feel anything because other than having a predominant thought about it, right? So when you're feeling all of those things, it is also a cue to adjust the script. So your emotions are a cue as well. So if you are feeling expectant of the thing that you desire, and you have this really strong, have you ever had that like really strong expectation? Something's about to happen that's going to be right in alignment with what I desire, versus that strong expectation. Oh my God, something bad's going to happen. Something bad's going to happen. That's a different emotion, right? But that emotion is occurring again, just as a cue. Girlfriend, rewrite the script, change the script, and you change it vibrationally, okay? Sometimes writing it out actually does help as well, but the key thing is to know that you can shift it vibrationally as well. So number four is see all of the unwanted emotions as a cue to adjust the script as well, because a lot of times we feel unwanted emotions and we give it meaning, like, oh, here am I feeling fear again. I thought I conquered this fear. See, this isn't working. And we go through, we give it all kinds of different meanings, Well, just give it the meaning that I just need to adjust the script. Just give me a moment. Need to go take a walk out in nature and begin readjusting the script. Need to go meditate so I can adjust the script. Need to go spend some time alone so I can adjust the script. Need to come up with some, not come up with, but allow the emergence of a different way of seeing this, giving this a new meaning so that I can adjust the script. Okay, so that's number four. See your emotions as a cue to adjust the script as well. Number five. Now, y'all heard me talk about this in more than one video. And I'll direct you to the video that I did on affirmations, and an affirmayhem. Number five is cease all affirmayhems. Okay? This is where you're writing, and listen, I love y'all, but you do not need to write all of the bad things that are happening in your life under a video of mine. I understand that you're saying these things are happening and your video is helping me, and that's cool. But what I want you to understand is if you're putting in comments about the things that are not occurring, you are actually creating. You cannot, I say this to my clients all the time, and I'll say it to you viewers as well. You cannot articulate a thing that's happening in your life that is unwanted and not re-experience that. Let me say that again. You cannot get behind your keyboard and type up what's happening in your life that is unwanted and not re-experience everything that you're typing. And as you are re-experiencing it, guess what you're doing? Your vibe is in resonance with the thing that is unwanted, sending vibe out into the universe, bringing more of that unwanted thing back to you. It is not necessary. Okay? You can tell me, like, say something is happening with a spouse or a family member, and all they're just like, somebody wrote, and I haven't responded to you yet, but you wrote something about your parents not understanding your perspectives and things like that. You could say that in like one sentence without reliving everything in written form or even in verbal form. Sometimes I say to clients all the time, if you're on the phone with me and you're like going on and on and on about what's not happening, at the end of which I go, well, that was a beautiful affirmation, because you just sent a big giant vibe out into the universe that you want more of this. Okay. You don't have to go there. There's another video that I did on how to ask questions that cause you to manifest more of what you desire. Look at that video and look at the examples that I offered in that video, because you can literally feel the vibe of asking a question that helps you manifest more of what you desire. So you don't have to regurgitate everything that's happening in your life in order for me to respond. You can just say, Allison, I'm having an unwanted situation with a family member right now, and it's causing these things to occur. But you don't have to go, just spend like just a little, like one sentence. Give yourself like one sentence to describe it and not go so far into it that you're causing your situation and your circumstance to reoccur in your vibe. Why would you want to do that? And the reason we do, and I talked about that in the video on affirmations, affirmayhem, it's like, no, Allison, the only reason I put it all out there is because I want you to understand what's going on. I don't need all the detail because my answer is the same anyway. Shift your vibe to get more of what you want. It doesn't change. It really doesn't. Now, it's customized to what you're going through and what your experiences are for sure when I'm working with my clients, but it's not that different. It's really not that different. I simply give you what I would give you anyway. You don't have to put that much detail. It is not necessary to get on the phone and tell people all the stuff that's happening in your life simply to justify why you're feeling fearful, to justify why you're feeling scared, to justify why you're pissed off. I don't need to hear all of that. Just say, there's some unwanted stuff that's going on. It's causing me to feel a lot of fear, and I want some insight on that. I mean, you could be that brief, okay? Because it doesn't shift and change based on what you tell me. I already know that you are the vibrational writer of the script of your life. I already know that nothing can happen in our experiences unless we are a vibrational match to it. So the answer is the same anyway. Shift your vibe to what you prefer. Go back to the script, rewrite the script. You are the director of the script of your life. Do not let your circumstance be the director of your life. It is not. You are. Okay, the same thing is, I'll say it in different ways, but it's the same thing. So, number five is cease all affirmations. That's what I call you regurgitating, me regurgitating everything that's happening that we do not want. It is a affirmation. We think that the only time we're doing affirmations is when we have that beautiful little script in front of us that we're reading out to make us feel better in front of the mirror or whatever. No, every word you utter is an affirmation. Unfortunately, it's an affirmation when you're uttering words that of things that you do not want, when you're writing things that you do not want. And I always have to watch that in my own life as well. Sometimes I'll start to write something back to a client, or I'm sharing a story of something that happened to me, and we feel like we have to share all the horrific details so people will identify, so they'll understand why we are where we are. You don't have to justify where you are. In fact, don't identify with where you are. Identify with your preferred reality. Make all of your look. Somebody asks, "How's the situation going?" It is awesome. I have never felt better. Even if that's not how you feel, but it's how you want to feel, might as well move in the direction of how you want to feel. I'm starting to understand that I am the director of the script of my life, and I am affirming all of the things that's going well for me right now. I am seeing more and more of that's what you want to write. Okay, don't write the things that you do not want, because you're regurgitating all. You cannot write that without re-experiencing the fear, the desperation. You cannot rewrite the anger, the frustration. You cannot rewrite what's happening that's unwanted without reliving it. So go to those other videos that I did, the one on affirmations and affirmation. You might want to look at that again. And the other one, and I'll put the links up here somewhere. And the other one on how to ask questions that allow you to manifest more of what you desire. So those are the five things that I wanted to share in terms of vibrationally directing the script of your life. But the most powerful one is see yourself as the director. And as things play out, just go, obviously, I need to rewrite the script on this one. Okay. And realize that you can. In any given moment, you can go back to the paper and rewrite the script, okay? Now I say that, just as a metaphor, but we all came into this planet, people, knowing that we had the power to rewrite the script. No matter what was unfolding in our experience, we knew before we got here we had the power to rewrite the script. And we can do that at any point in time. We can do that. So hopefully that was helpful to you. So to those of you who have been asking about my monthly event, yes, it's still, I was going to go do that for 3 months, and this would have been the last month. I think I will continue it. You can find out more about that at allisonphillips.tv/shift. I do need to change that webpage because a lot has shifted in how I do that event. Right now, I'm doing 1 week, I'm doing Q&A. I'm allowing everybody to have some one-on-ones with me at this time. So I need to change that page, and I'm also seeing a different perspective of how I'm really experiencing that event. So I probably have to shoot a different video to really share what it has unfolded to be as well. But it's a lot of fun for me, and I'm spending a lot of my time there in that monthly event because it's not just the one-time event. I'm actually communicating with the people that are participating just about every week in terms of them posting questions and asking questions about different things that's happening in their lives. And it's just a lot of fun for me to be helping people really truly become the directors of the script of their lives. So if you want to hang out with me and come chat with me about something that's happening in your life, I'm more than happy to support you further in that. Well, that is it for this episode of the show. Hopefully, it was helpful to you guys. Hopefully, it gave you more clarity on how you can become the vibrational writer of the script of your life as well. You already are. You already are. It's not like something you have to start. You just need to adjust the script a little bit, right? In terms of what you desire and what you don't desire in your life. So, thanks again for being with me, and I hope you guys have a wonderful week. I'll see you in the next episode. Bye for now.
Thank you for joining us for today's show. And remember to take what resonates and discard what does not. Your inner being, soul, and spirit knows what is best for you at any given time. So we encourage you to trust the wisdom of your own inner voice regarding everything Allison has shared today. To find out more about the show or to find out more about Allison's coaching and speaking, you may go to allisonphillips.tv.